Hey everyone, just a quick video today and I'm a little bit rough and ready. My hair's a bit crazy, but I hope you don't mind. I'm just gonna go for it anyway while I've got the chance. Today I wanna show you how to do the Zap test for pH testing your soap. You can use this test for cold process, hot process soap, and I'm pretty sure, I haven't tried it, but I'm pretty sure you can also use it for pH testing liquid soap paste. So there you go. So the Zap test, lots of us have heard about it. I thought I knew a bit about it when I first started soap making, but then I discovered these things, pH test strips, which you've probably seen in a lot of my videos. These are great. Honestly, if you can get these, and I just bought these off eBay, and I do have a video that demonstrates how I use these, so I'll link to that in the description box. If you can get these are great. These are fine, bit of paper, wet soap, test the pH and you'll know if your soap is safe enough to use or not. And why is this important? Well, if you have any experience with soap making, you know that soap starts off with the use of quite dangerous alkaline chemicals, either sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, which are highly caustic. You know, they're corrosive. They will burn your skin and soap takes a little while for that chemical reaction to complete after it's made, and when it's fully saponified, it's safe to use and there's no more sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide left in the soap. So we soap makers, we need to test our soap to make sure that they're safe for us to use or for us to give to other people or whatever we're doing with them. And I do advocate for pH test strips if you can get them, but if you cannot get them, there is an alternative. And I know a lot of you can't get them, so this is for you. In this book, Scientific Soap Making by Kevin Dunn, honestly, I don't think I'll ever read the entire book, but I do pick out bits and pieces, and I've read a fair chunk of it. He dedicates 2.5 pages to what he calls the tongue test. And really, that's the other term for the Zap test. And it is really the old way of testing soap before we had litmus paper, you know, pH paper. Kevin in his book says, the tongue is the oldest chemical sensor we have, and soap makers have been using it for as long as there has been soap. So that was really reassuring for me to read. So in this book, he teaches you the best way to do it, and I'm going to share that method or my slightly changed version of that method with you. It is very, very easy. All you need is a finished bar of soap. Hopefully it is safe to test and all you're going to taste is soap. But what you do to do the Zap test is you wet your finger. I'm going to use water, but you could, you know, use a bit of saliva as well. Wet your finger, rub it onto the soap till you get a bit of a slurry going on, till you get a bit of soap on your finger. And then, yep, put it on your tongue. Just a little tiny bit and just see what you can taste. So I know this soap is fully saponified. It just tastes like soap. It's a little bit oily, a little bit soapy. There's nothing else going on there though. Just tastes like soap. There's no stinging or anything like that. If this soap wasn't fully saponified and the chemical reaction was incomplete, or there was a mistake in the recipe and too much lye was added, or something went wrong and the soap was not safe to use and it was lye heavy or unsaponified for some reason, this is Kevin's description of what you will experience. And I have tested it out. It's pretty good description. Imagining that your finger is covered with deadly poison, touch it delicately to the tip of your tongue. Perhaps you taste nothing, in which case you can taste more boldly the second time. Eventually, you will taste something that tastes like fat, like soap, or like some terrible, stinging, bitter, salty something that you would prefer never to have taste again. Blah, 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 spit it out, basically. He says, don't worry, rinse your mouth out with water and remember that taste. That is the taste of alkali. So basically, you will, if your soap is not fully saponified or it is lye heavy or it has too much alkali in it, you will get a tingly, zappy, electrical charge, little zap taste when you test your soap. And try it out. Try it on soap that you've made maybe the day before, or soap that you think may be close to being saponified but not fully. And do that little taste. And if you don't get any stinging or weird zappy feeling, and you just can taste soap like I can, then it will be fine. If your soap is not fine and you are getting the zap, if your recipe was correct and you measured everything properly, then you just need to give it more time. It just needs more time to fully saponify and become the correct pH. By the way, soap, completed soap, is always a naturally slightly alkaline product. It will always be about 8 or 9 on the pH scale. So the pH test strips will always come up green if your soap is ready. It'll pass the Zap test. But if it's higher than that and your paper's coming out purple, or it's really zappy and you think it should have saponified by then there may be something wrong with it. But give it a good few days. Sometimes it can take a few days to fully saponify. If it is still zappy after a week, then there's something gone wrong with your soap recipe and you'd need to evaluate what happened with it, and you may need to rebatch it with some more oil. It's very hard to do if you don't know what went wrong, but if you know what went wrong, that's pretty easy to correct. But that's a subject for a whole other video. Anyway, just wanted to show you the Zap test. It's not that scary and it's a legit method. You can do it. When I first started soap making, I was really quick to get these because I just didn't want to play around with the Zap test. It sounded too, dangerous to me. I didn't want to put raw soap on my tongue, but it is a legitimate method and not everybody has access to pH test strips, and they're not always easy to get for everybody in all parts of the world. So use the Zap test, and that way, at least in one capacity, you will know that your soap is safe to use. Thanks for watching. I hope that was helpful. Please head to the description box below the video if you want to check out any links. I'll put links to this book, to my website, other relevant things I may think of. And if you would like to buy me a coffee to support my work, I would appreciate that a lot as well. I'll put the link for that below too. I hope you're all well. I'll see you again soon.